What's up, everybody? And I don't know why we never did a webisode of how we met, our story, and some things that we're noticing that God is kind of doing similar with other people's story. So let's go. First off, this was back in like 2011. I was a student pastor. I was responsible for roughly 40 to 50 young adults and high school students, and I didn't like the music they were listening to. I just wasn't really feeling it, so that caused me to start doing music. I was not trying to be a rapper. I was not trying to start a rap career. I just was really trying to find something that they could listen to besides the toxic music that they were listening to. And so I didn't know that God was gonna use that to have me go to other churches. I didn't know that I would start touring, doing music.
A rapper, y'all.
Like a rapper.
His name was Jay Flow.
And I actually did music with KB and The Truth. I had no idea that would cause me to get booked in Oklahoma City, where I first saw, well, not first saw, I guess you can kind of expound, because I saw her like a year before at a funeral. She was with another guy at that time. And it was kind of crazy because I saw my wife before she was my wife.
So I was working and living in Oklahoma City after college, teaching, and I was attending a church. Active in ministry there, very active in the worship team, and the ministry of arts, and just other, I was very active, always doing church stuff. My pastor at the time was going to minister at an event, and he had been announcing that his cousin, who happened to be Jerry, was going to be coming in town. And say, hey, come and support this concert or this event that he's gonna be preaching at and that his cousin was coming to. I was like, you know what, I'm not doing nothing, I might as well go. So I went really just to support my pastor. And then I had to end up, he started doing worship, I ended up having to come on stage and do some worship background behind him. I went to his table because he had, you know, little products on the table, and he was like, I remember you, I recognize you.
I did.
And I was, it kind of freaked me out, because I had never seen him before in my life. So for you to say, I know you, he remembered me. And he was like, yeah, at the funeral, because that year prior, I believe, my pastor's father had passed away. And so I went to the funeral, I attended it, and he was there because they're, you know, relatives. And so I bought a CD, you know, to support his ministry, you know, young artist trying to do his thing. And so,
why you bought a CD?
I really did. I bought a CD to support his, to support him, because I did try to support, you know, local artists, especially when they were doing stuff for the kingdom. So,
hold on. Before you go any further, she's leaving out pertinent information.
What did I leave out?
The dude that I saw, like the guy that she was with, mm-hmm. that I saw the year before at the funeral, they had like this church breakup.
Yeah.
And you know, church breakups can be messy.
They can.
You don't know mess until you have ever experienced a church breakup.
Yeah.
Hold on to the website. But anyway, if she would have left, because the pain was real severe,
mm-hmm.
if she would have left the church due to the hurt, when I came along to sing, we never would have crossed paths. So sometimes pain does not mean leave. Just because it's a pain place doesn't mean God can't change it into a praise place. Don't make me preach in this webisode.
God actually ended up moving the individual. Because, you know, I loved my church. I was planted in my church. I served very faithfully there, so I wasn't trying to leave, but God ended up moving them, so it worked out. So later that evening of the concert, back to that, it was a bunch of people that actually came to support from the church. So we, about, I would say 15 of us, went to dinner, my pastor, him, other friends of mine, and so we were kind of playing eye tag at the table. I like to say he was kind of staring at me, kind of like, you know, he couldn't keep his eyes off of me, and I was kind of feeling like, oh my God, like, his cousin just keeps staring at me.
That's why you kept looking
my direction. It's a little awkward, right? He touched me as he was leaving. Pastor had to take him back to his hotel because we had church the next morning. I felt this hard hit on my... You're super heavy.
It was like a bye tap.
It was like a goodbye tap.
God must have been giving her like a, hey, girl.
But that was his way. Later on, that was his way of saying, hey, I noticed you.
That night, I had a dream. A tornado was coming to my...
Well, that's your stuff.
No, it was both of our stuff, because it was confirmation to me. I had a dream that night that a tornado was coming to my hotel.
Okay, he told me that. Later.
And in the dream, she was standing at the door, you know, with the door open. I'm like, how did you get here? And she's like, I'm here to help you. Come on. That kind of like during service the next day, since I had that dream, you know, help you.
Yeah.
I just couldn't keep my eyes off of her after that.
Right. And then I believe you asked my pastor when he picked you up, didn't you ask him about, did you ask him about me?
I did.
He was gathering his research.
I started investigating.
He started doing his research on me. Yeah. My pastor that morning was ministering on clarity, right? And finding clarity, getting clarity from God. And at that stage in my life, I had two men pursuing me that I really didn't want to be with either of them.
Huh.
I really didn't, but I felt like it was obviously not you. I didn't want to be really with either of them, but I was kind of maybe getting to the point where I was like, maybe I should settle. Maybe my standards are too high. Maybe I'm tripping. Maybe I should give these guys a chance. The message just hit so home for me because that's where I felt like I needed God. I needed answers because I had been through enough failed relationships that I was not about to make a commitment to either of these guys if I didn't have that clarity that, hey, one of these men is your husband. And I remember asking God, like, God, the next man that I really get involved in a relationship, seriously, I want to be my husband or I'll just be single. Like that, I remember that. And I remember really, really crying out to God on the altar that Sunday. Like, God, please give me clarity. I want you to tell me, I want you to show me, because these guys were pursuing me pretty heavily. And I was like, I don't want to make a mistake. I don't want to be with the wrong person. I just don't.
She was at the altar and I was on the front pew. And it was like God was answering her in her face. She's like, let the next man be my husband. And I was sitting there looking at her like, I wonder what she's going through.
Yeah, I was, you know, I was really crying out.
Which is just really powerful that I guess God knew at that moment is the time where I'm going to introduce you to my will for your life.
Because yeah. I was at kind of at my end. I really was. I was like, I'm done making bad decisions.
Yeah.
So I was after church. I was in a meeting. And his cousin, the pastor's son, who was like 10 or 11 years old, came to get me and said, hey, J Flo wants to speak to you, which is extra bold, right?
Like, I don't know why I was that bold.
Super, I'm in an actual meeting. And he comes and gets me and say, J Flo wants to talk to you. And I'm like, oh, okay. So he pulls me out. I go to the back of the church. He's like, hey, I just, you know, want to say it was really great meeting you and let's stay connected, you know, let's stay in touch. And I'm like, okay, yeah, sure, yeah. Why not? He's like, no, for real. And I'm like, okay. And he said, I sent you a message on Facebook, but you haven't answered yet. Yeah. And I was like, well, we got home pretty late last night.
The dream messed me up, man.
So we got home at like 11 o'clock, so I don't just check my Facebook, you know. At that point in my life, Facebook, I wasn't really on it like that. So I was like, I don't really check my messages like that. So
in other words,
I'll check it when I get a chance.
In other words, sometimes he can slide in your DMs.
Back when it wasn't really called DMs.
It wasn't called that. And I really wasn't trying to slide in the DMs or nothing. It's just the dream that I had caused me, for real. I was so caught up with what was going on in my youth ministry that it caused me to do something to really try to get them to focus on Christ. And it was hard to catch this woman. She had like two or three jobs. She was going on mission trips to Tanzania. She was discipling a small group, like a P12 group. She was in pageantry, just like she was just.
Yeah, I was heavily.
She was heavily involved. We don't know what it means to be bored and single.
But there were times that I would be really busy, and there'd be like, I just want to be at home at night.
She was never home.
This Friday night, I'm gonna be at home with my dog because I am always out doing something. Which was, I mean, I think that's what you should do in your unmarried state. You should maximize every moment. You should be busy, you should be active, you should be, I mean, especially doing what God wants you to do, pursuing purpose. And if you don't know, like, get involved in a bunch of stuff and then maybe you can discover your purpose.
I will say this though, I wasn't her preference.
No, he wasn't.
I was younger than her.
Yes.
I was in a total different
city. State.
Mm-hmm. She met me as a typical rapper.
A rapper.
I mean, I was a pastor.
He was a pastor.
That was
but
my
he
occupation.
Was a rapper. Like, he was a rapper, though. Yeah. I was like, you know.
I mean, she tried to kind of diss me for that.
I mean, I did. He like, had bars. Like, listen, let me make it clear. No, babe, he had bars. He still has bars. I mean, some of you that watch our stuff knows he has bars. But I was still kind of like, okay, but what? You know what? What else do you do? If I would have went off the fact that, oh, he's a rapper and he's younger than me and he lives in a different city, I would have missed my blessing. Like, real talk. I would have missed my blessing. I would have missed this awesome kingdom man. So
kingdom work collides you with kingdom partners. And we'll go on later to talk about how we transition from meeting to knowing.
Yeah, how we kind of started our relationship.
From meeting to
what
knowing.
What that looked like.
Yeah. So, Redefine TV.
Or Redefining Relationships.
Righteously.